You join me today here at Decoy Lakes, and this is Lou's Lake at the fishery. It's the middle of December, it's been freezing cold, and the water is absolutely gene clear. And this time of year, it's a little bit more difficult to get a few bites, but I'm going to show you a couple of really simple things you can do to get a few bites and maybe put a few more fish in your net. And it's all about the colour of your bait. Basically, I'm fishing with a hybrid feeder with micros and a pellet. That was my first cast. The only difference being as normal, it's nothing to do with rigs or the weight of the feeder or anything like that. But what I'm using is black pellets. We wouldn't consider going fishing in the summer. Say if we were using ground bait, we wouldn't consider using anything other than like a natural coloured bait. But when we go in the winter, we swap that round to a darker bait because it doesn't spook the fish. It's less obtrusive on the bottom, so the fish come over it. So why wouldn't we apply the same thing to pellets? You know, it makes perfect sense to me that in cold and clear water, you use a black pellet. Well, obviously, you need to use a pellet where the colour doesn't come off. That's super important because, you know, otherwise you're just left with a sort of a grey coloured thing on the bottom. But if you've got a pellet and the colour doesn't come off and it's attractive to the fish, it works every time. The pellets I'm using today are from Peg No. 1. They're the squid and krill micros with a 6mm squid and krill micro hook bait. The colour doesn't come off. They really smell. And as you can see, first chuck, I've had a fish. Why black pellets? Well, why not black pellets? It makes perfect sense as an angler when the water goes clear to use a darker bait. These are Peg No. 1 squid and krill pellets. These are 2mm that are damped up for the feeder. You can use them through a pole, doesn't really matter. And they come in 2, 4, 6 and 8mm sizes, just like a standard pellet. They have got a strong squid and fish meal aroma, but they work just like a normal pellet, but they are black and it does give you that little bit of edge. And like I said, the colour doesn't come off in the water, which is hugely important for me. But that isn't the only trick I've got on my sleeve when it comes to using coloured baits. Now the other little edge that I would use on a day like this when the water is so clear is this. This is Peg No. 1's pink almond corn. Now, pink baits are not new for match anglers. You think fluoro pink has worked really well, especially in cold water, and the carp anglers really do rate sort of pink pop-ups, pink boilers or wafters, and the almond flavour and things like goo that you could put on other baits also is really popular, especially when there's carp. It's proven to work. Now, unlike the pellets, where obviously you're feeding a few pellets and, you know, maybe one or two fish are hanging around, with this type of bait, I feed very, very little in clear water. Sort of 3-4 grains is more than enough. I truly believe that they're drawn towards the colour. It's a little bit different from yellow, but it still stands out. And I think on venues that are heavily fished with corn, it just gives you that little bit extra. And when it's clear, I think they really do home in on it and they like the flavour. So for me, when it's clear, I take a can with me. It's not expensive and I do believe it brings me extra bites. Just hooked my first fish on the coloured bit of corn. I'm not feeding very heavily because, like I spoke about at the start, I really believe that they home in on the colour and they're not really ever going to eat much this time of year. The water's too cold. So I think as long as there's not too much there to spook them, I think they're intrigued by the colour and it's got a really nice flavour. And I, you know, I'm feeding like 2 or 3 grains and I've no more than that. And that's my first fish. I think it's probably an F1, which doesn't surprise me, but let's have a look. Yeah, nice enough F1, but would I have caught that on an ordinary bait? You know, that's a great thing about fishing, you're never sure, but what I am sure about it is it took a piece of pink sweet corn and it's a decent fish, and just maybe, that pink colour gave me an edge. It It's quite late in the afternoon. It's been a beautiful December day, really. We've been blessed with the weather and the sun's still shining, but the sky's incredibly clear. So when that sun dips behind the horizon over there, it's going to be proper cold again. So I've decided that this is going to be my last fish of the day. I've caught on black pellets as feed and as hook bait. I've been really happy with that. And I've had a few fish on the corn, a little bit slower on the corn line, but we have had a few fish. As expected, they're mainly F1s. But would I have caught with ordinary baits? Quite possibly. I mean, this is a great venue and there's lots of fish, but I don't know, you know, you sort of ring the changes, try something else. Baits aren't expensive, so why wouldn't you try it? Definitely the black pellets, though. I'm becoming more and more sold on black pellets in clear water. I mean, I had a play with them last year when they first came out. Now I'm really convinced that they do bring me an odd fish. Look at that, that's my biggest fish of the day as well. So we're really pleased with that. So I'm gonna net this one, and that will be the end of my day. But that's been very interesting. I think I've learned a little bit. I've hardly used any bait, but I've enjoyed myself. I've had the lake to myself, and that's been a lot of fun. Obviously, I've forgotten how to net fish. It's not ideal. I mean, you think you know, at my age, you think you know how that worked. But that's definitely the best fish of the day. Nice common. Well, that's my final fish of the session, and that, as they say, is that really nice dark common on the black pellet. Can't moan about that. And I've had a great few hours in the middle of December.